infinity. Life crawls from the past, watching in wonder. I trace its patterns in me.
Bye. tell us, how did you get together again?
We have stayed friends through all the period, all the 27 years. And at a certain point, we realized that we actually had to address the fact of, are we ever going to play together as Van de Graaff again or not? And we decided that we'd have an experiment and just go away very quietly and secretly by ourselves and see if there was something to be done, which evidently there was, because the unit still works. And so then we emerged into this brief late flowering of a career. It's not, you know, I mean, I have to say that, you know, it's not necessarily a kind of an absolute rock or band career or what have you. It's playing things for the moment that we're in. And that's, I think, has always been part of the Van de Graaff ethos, to be honest. And certainly as something that we've carried through into this current incarnation, as I think is evident by tonight's show.
I think if there was ever an unorthodox career in rock, then it was you.
Yeah, it's not really. Career is maybe too strong a word, actually, isn't it? Yeah.
Well, at the end of the day, the music counts. You
know? Exactly. At the end of the day, the music and the doing of the music and I think for all of us, the way in which we do the music is the important thing. That, you know, it's without boundaries, to be honest. Part of the deal about Van de Graaff from the very earliest days was that we were not interested in boundaries, in being a group that was allied particularly with any particular strand of music. That at certain moments we would play things that were like ballads, at certain moments we'd play things that are completely free jazz, at certain moments we'd play almost heavy metal. Granted, the fact that the main instruments are organ and sax, not generally noted as the main heavy metal instruments, but, you know, we like a bit of power, we like a bit of delicacy and so on, so, yeah. That's the spirit, I think.
Oh, man. Mr. Is a mine.
By this we are all sustained. Our belief in human nature and in justice and parity. All we have is the face to carry on. Imperceptible, the change. As one by one our voices falter, lords and masters determined to cast us in the roles of serfs and slaves in the new empire's name. Yes, and every bloody emperor claims that freedom is his cause, as he buffs up on his common touch as a gain of claws. Unto nations, nations speak in the language of the garter, trading prime time insults. The imperial impulse extends across the screen. We'll be right back. susceptible to change. As one by one our voices falter, and the double standards of propaganda fuel all our righteous rage. By this we are all sustained. Our belief in human nature, but our faith diminishes close to the finish. We're only serfs and slaves as the empire decays.
The real Van der Graaf story begins when I went in 68, 69, and joined up with Hugh and began working in London. If we'd been even a year later, I don't think we'd have had the tenacity to go on and do the stuff that we'd done. But it was a very, very exciting time.
But what was it? What sparked all this off? Do you have any explanation?
Well, it was an open era, you know. We were, the media were gradually opening up. There were communications between cultures. I suppose drugs have an element to do with this as well, to be honest. There was a feeling that there was the feeling actually that anything was possible, and that the world might genuinely change as a result of music or as a result of art or something like that. It was just the spirit that was in the air.
You consider your group being part of the psychedelic movement?
I think the psychedelic movement was really an American thing. That's, I think, Big Brother, Jefferson Airplane, all that kind of thing. In Britain, the deal was more the underground movement, which is, it has a parallel, but it's not quite the same thing. Certainly when we started, we were an underground group. But partly because we couldn't be defined in any other way. That's essentially the problem. And I do have to say, still, I hate the idea of being defined down to anything.
Mm-hmm.
I like music of all kinds. And as long as the heart and the spirit and the soul are properly in it, it's proper music.
Killer lives inside me. Yes, I can feel him move. Sometimes he's lightly sleeping in the quiet. His room. my cloisters hang the acolytes of gloom, and death sent throws his cloak into the corner of my room. Thank you. live in the bottom of the sea, and you kill all that come. We hop around on the highest cliff top, and down around is all that I can see. For those alive would dearly love to share it, crashing up quite blindly through the sea. I tried to ask what name this was, but knew I would not play it. The voice has won, but no one. I don't know why.